हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर द क्लास फाइव. फॉर क्लास फाइव लेट मी चेंज दिस पेन कलर. ओके, सो दिस इज लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर क्लास फाइव एंड दिस लेक्चर विल बी इन इंग्लिश ओनली. ओके, सो इफ यू गाइज फील सम प्रॉब्लम विद इंग्लिश डैट यू आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड इन इंग्लिश प्रॉपरली, यू कैन टेल मी इन कमेंट सेक्शन और इन योर व्हाट्सएप सेक्शन और ऑन व्हाट्सएप. And definitely I will make this lecture in Hindi also, okay? In complete Hindi or I will use mixed up. It's all up to you that what is your response. If you want, then I will make a mixed lecture that is Hindi as well as English combined, okay? So it's all up to you which kind of lecture you will prefer. Okay, so this is your IT Planet book for class 5. For class 5. Okay, this is your lecture number 2. Actually, this is your lecture 2, but from today I will start the proper syllabus. In last class I just told you about the basics of computer. Now today we will start with chapter number 1, which is generation of computer. What better? Generation of computer. So first of all, what we have to read? We have to read generation of computer. In this chapter we will study about generation of computer, first, second, third, fourth and fifth generation. Means that what we have to read? We have to read only these five generation. What do we mean by generation? Generation means whenever there is so much change. There is so much change, a big change in any technology. Means that as you can see in your devices, there was 2G. If you ask your parents, then they will tell you there was a time when we was using 2G. Now after that we used 3D and now we are having 4G and we will have 5G very soon. Some companies have tested this positively, so maybe in some future we will see 5G also. So as you know, in 2G means second generation. If you ask about your parents who used 2G, then they will tell you that in second generation computer, there in second generation network, the network speed was very low. It was about 16 kbps. Means that you won't be able to watch on YouTube. You can skip the YouTube, but you're not able to scroll the web pages. Even you won't be able to open the web pages in 2G. And after that there was 3G, who made speed more higher, and now we are using 4G. Same way, these are the generation in the network. These are the generation in network. Now today we will see same way generation in case of computer. Okay, I think you guys are ready for it. If you are not, then please let me know. Okay, first of all, my point is that if you are not able to understand in English, so please let me know. Please let me know so that I will make a lecture for Hindi also, because there is not any kind of meaning if I unable to understand the things. If you're not able to understand the things, so this is nothing for me. Okay, now generation of computer. First of all, welcome to your new class, because you have promoted from class 4 to class 5. Okay, now here you have to read about generation. As we all have generation in our family, like suppose it is grandfather and then grandmother, okay, parents, then children. Okay, so these are the generation, that your grandfather is a generation, then your father, and then you, and then as extras. Okay, so this is the generation. Same way computer generation are there. So as you can see, the first generation computer, like in UNIVAC, was the first generation computer was designed so badly, so much big in size, that it should kept in a single room. Can you imagine, in a single room there is only a computer, only nothing else. Then it moves to the personal computer, which look like this, you can see. And after that, desktop computer, which looks like this. Then all-in-one computer, which is look like this. Then notebook, then tablet, then a smartphone, and then Intel computer stick. So let me explain you all these things one by one. UNIVAC was first generation computer. What beta? First generation computer. Then personal computer was there. डेस्कटॉप कंप्यूटर, आई थिंक यू गाइज आर फेमिलियर विथ इट। ऑल इन वन इज़ अ कंप्यूटर इन विच देर इज ओनली अ सिंगल मॉनिटर हैविंग ऑल द सीपीयू विथ मॉनिटर। मीन्स दैट यू हैव टू प्लग इन योर कीबोर्ड एंड माउस इन दिस, यू हैव टू प्लग इन योर कीबोर्ड एंड माउस इन द गिवन पोर्ट ऑफ सीपीयू, इन द गिवन पोर्ट ऑफ मॉनिटर ओनली एंड यू विल गेट द सीपीयू। देन नोटबुक लाइक योर लैपटॉप, लैपटॉप इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड नोटबुक, एंड देन टैबलेट पी सी, स्मार्टफोन डेट यू आर यूजिंग, एंड इंटेल कंप्यूटर स्टिक, इट इज़ अ स्टिक डेट कैन कन्वर्ट एनी एच डी एम आई पोर्ट सिस्टम। मीन्स दैट इफ यू हैव एनी डिस्प्ले विच सपोर्ट्स एच डी एम आई पोर्ट, देन यू कैन कन्वर्ट दिस सिस्टम, दिस स्क्रीन टू अ स्मार्टफोन डिवाइस, स्मार्ट डिवाइस लाइक अ कंप्यूटर। ओके, नाउ जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर, जनरेशन मीन्स रिमार्केबल इंप्रूवमेंट इन एनी प्रोडक्ट, सो वी कैन से दैट जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर मीन्स रिमार्केबल इंप्रूवमेंट ऑफ द ग्रोथ ऑफ द डेवलपमेंट इन द कंप्यूटर टेक्नोलॉजी। सो वेन एवर वी से रिमार्केबल मीन्स दैट अ ह्यूज चेंज फ्रॉम देयर, इट इज़ अ ह्यूज चेंज इज कॉल्ड चेंज ऑफ जनरेशन। द ग्रोथ ऑफ कंप्यूटर टुक्स प्लेस इन द फाइव डिस्टिंक्ट फेसेस कॉल्ड कंप्यूटर ऑफ जनरेशन कंप्यूटर ऑफ जनरेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स। The different computers generation are categorized according to their technology based complement. So how you will differentiate that this is the first, this is second, how you will? You will use technology, you will see which technology it used. Now the first generation computer. First generation computer was made up of the 1946 to 1958. This is the time period. After that 1958, the first generation computer, the production of first generation computer was finished. Means that after 1958, there was no any company that generates first generation computer. Okay, means that there is not any kind of use of it, nobody was using it. Okay, let's start. The first generation computer started in 1946, and the Marx used thousands of vacuum tube. Vacuum tube is a kind of tube, air tube like this, which creates vacuum inside it. Vacuum means nothing, okay. It was very old technology that vacuum tube used. Okay, they were very expensive, huge amount of electricity, and generate a lot of heat. There was such a lot of heat that you can't even imagine. Okay, now the first generation computer uses machine language. Let me see. Okay, so the first generation computer uses machine language, which was lowest programming language understood by the computer. So in the this programming language we used machine level language like 10110011, something like that, which was very typical to understand and very bad to understand at that time. Okay, so it uses machine level language. Now what is the feature? It was very big in size, operating speeds very slow. Operating speed kya thi? Very slow. They were very expensive. They used devices called vacuum tube. ENIAC, UNIVAC was example. Drawback, produce a lot of heat, not reliable. They can hang up, they can stop working anytime. Okay, they use machine language as a lower programming language. As I told you, what is machine level language? Machine level language was some kind of 101100 kind of language. In a language, there only 1 and 0 was used. It's called machine level language. Okay, yeah, isko kya kehte hain? Machine level language, MLL. Okay, now here's the structure of vacuum tube. You can see. Now, after that, second generation computer was launched in 1959 to 1964. Now you can ask me a doubt, which is that it was 1958, and here you can see after 958 we have 959. Okay, so it means that in 958 द जनरेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर मीन्स दैट क्रिएशन ऑफ फर्स्ट जनरेशन वॉज स्टॉप्ड कम्प्लीटली स्टॉप्ड नो कंपनी वी आर मेकिंग फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर फ्रॉम 1959 सेकेंड जनरेशन कंप्यूटर वॉज ऑन द ग्राउंड मीन्स दैट इफ़ यू आस्क टू योर पेरेंट्स देन यू विल केम टू नो दैट अर्लियर डेज टीवी वॉज सो बिग कॉल्ड TFT टीवी and your parents, your grandparents must be seen in this type of TV. Now, you are having a slim TV. Very lightweight, very good picture quality is called slim TV. And you might be comfortable with it. So, if you ask your parents and you will see that this so big TV is not in function anymore. If you wanted to buy this TV, you won't be able to buy it because it's not in the market even. You will not find it anywhere in any shop. Why? Because it is not in function. Same way, here is your second generation computer. Okay, let me talk about the second generation computer. They use transistor in place of vacuum tube, so the transistor were far superior than the vacuum tube. Allows the computer to become smaller, faster, cheaper, and more reliable than the first generation computer. So one vacuum tube is equal to 40 transistor. Means that you have to use 40 transistor instead of one vacuum tube. Okay. Now, the size of the transistor you can see is only this. Okay, this is the size of transistor. Transistor is works with the. Shall I tell you or not? Reverse. Oh, okay, just leave it. No. You won't be able to understand that. So, second generation computer assembly level language assembly language instead of machine level language. IBM 140 Mark III Leo as well as example of the this generation of computer. This generation are the smaller than the first generation of computer. Speed was fast, cost get reduced. Okay, means you have to pay less amount and you will get faster speed. Drawback, produces a lot of heat like previous one. Speed is still slow, memory was less. Same in the third generation computer, the time spent is here. We used integrated circuit IC in the semiconductor chip. This chip makes our computers smaller, reliable, and keyboards and monitor which are infected with the operating system. Here we used operating system also, and then generate less heat, and it was supports like COBOL and Fortran language, which is high level language in which you can coding in like English language. Okay, fourth generation computer uses microprocessor. These are microprocessor are very small, thousands of integrated circuit, means that a lot of integrated circuit IC commonly called microcontroller. Okay, you can also write is micro controller. This is the sign of microcontroller. Let me make it clear. Micro controller. Okay, this is the sign of microcontroller. So these are the computer became more powerful, could link together, form the network. Here we have the network also. Then the development of internet. These are the system that lead to the internet so fast. Okay. After that, what we have? We have Intel 4004. Apple Macintosh, IBM 370. This computer supports C, C++, Java also. These are the four generation computers, so small they can work even the desk and the palm of the hand. Okay. Personal computers also does, and Apple introduced Macintosh as I told you earlier. So here you can see these are the chip, and chip is very small. Here you can see in a finger there is a chip. So these microprocessor is multi-purpose computers, actually reliable and very fast. After this we have four generation of computer to present and beyond. This generation computer is based on the AI means artificial intelligence. Okay, they are still in the development. The main goal of the fusion computer is to develop the computer system that can respond to the natural language and compatible to the learning their own decision, for example robot. So what is the meaning of natural language? Natural language means Hindi, English, all the language that a human speak. It's called, if you know about this Siri, Google Assistant, Google Assistant, Siri, Alexa, then you know that these are the software that work with your voice. If you say that your Siri that set an alarm after 30 minutes, then it will set an alarm. So it will understand. So we are making some type of machine that can learn, and develop their self. So how they will learn? There are two type of learning in this case. For AI robotics, when I talk about the robotics, so then in robot there's two type of learning, supervision learning, and I think it will be so much for you. I think I should not tell it about this. Supervised and non-supervised and internal and external learning. So it will be so deep for you. I think that's all for today. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me. And see you next class. Bye everyone.